I'll be talking a bit more of where you can find the detailed part 2 of this video. As you might notice, this video is a collaboration between me and Virtual Vine. So the part 1, which is this video, will be talking about the financial aid application on a high level for a specified country, as you can see from the title of this video. The part 2 will be a screen walkthrough of how to look for financial aid for that specified country, and you can find the part 2 of this video in the video description and the comment section, and that will be hosted on the channel of Virtual Vine. Hope you find this video useful.
Hi, I'm Orthyonupam, an incoming freshman for biochemistry at the University of Oxford Exeter College, class of 2024. I'm from Bangladesh and I'm an ambassador for the Virtual Vine, which is a website dedicated to providing first-hand knowledge and available resources for college applications to international applicants through providing first-hand experiences of students currently in different universities across the globe. Today, I'm here to talk about the scholarship application process to the UK as part of the Virtual Vine special series on the financial aid application processes for colleges. This is actually part 1 of a 2-part video. I should probably begin this video, since it is mainly about the processes in the UK, by saying that the UK does not really have financial aid for international students. So most of the funding that you're applying for is either going to be from your home country, or it is going to be merit-based from the universities itself. Unlike the US universities, you don't actually have a website where you can compare the costs of different colleges in state and out of state side by side. However, you can use the UCAS app, you can use the UCAS website to search for colleges according to your needs, and they will usually provide you with links to the websites, which is equally good, if not more so. So I'm going to screen share now and show you the UCAS search tool. So you can just easily Google up UCAS, and it is quite easy to actually go to the website itself. With these kinds of websites, the key to actually finding what you need is to play around a bit, look for things that might interest you, that might help you. Here, if you scroll down, you can actually go to this sector called finance. So select finance and scroll down. There is undergraduate tuition fees. Select undergraduate tuition fees and you will come to this page where they're showing you the tuition fees for students in the UK and the EU. Also, for the EU from 2021 onwards, you guys will probably not be paying the same as the UK students. You will have a different tuition fee scale, so you should probably check that up at the gov.uk website. However, here, if you want to go to the search tool, click on the EU/international students, and they will provide you with a link to go to the UCAS search tool here. So click on the search tool, and this is actually a very interactive search tool, and you can just, since I applied for biochemistry, I'm going to type in biochemistry for an example for the year 2021 to 2022, although most universities still haven't published the 2021 fees. I'm going to give you 4 examples of 4 universities. Mainly, I'm going to compare the Oxford universities with 2 other universities in the UK. So here, that's UCL, and I'm going to click on the bachelor degree. In the case of UK, since the undergraduate degree is mostly 3-year, unlike in other countries, so it is usually less expensive since you have to pay for 1 year less than other universities. However, my course at Oxford is actually a 4-year degree, and it is actually quite expensive, but I'll get to that later. So for the UCL, you can see that the international fee for year one for 2020 was £26,490, which is actually around about the average, this is usually the average international student fee for good universities in the UK for science subjects. So you can actually look at the course specific fees by going to the link provided here for the BN funding. So Oxford has biochemistry for 4 years. This is also, it's written as M Biochem, but this is an undergraduate degree. They call it a master's degree because of the extra fourth year, which I've explained in a different video in the virtual line for the international student series. So here Oxford also shows an array of courses. They're showing the list of colleges that provide you with biochemistry. My college is Exeter, so I'm going to select Exeter in this case, and I'll click on view option and it will show me information regarding Exeter. The important thing here is that UCAS gives you a lot of information other than the tuition fees as well through the search tool, so it is quite helpful because it's showing you that the deadline, it shows you the application deadlines, which is 15th October for both Cambridge and Oxford, and for medicine students actually at any university. The application codes are something that you will need. This is something that you have to enter when you're applying using UCAS, so you should probably jot them down, campus name and everything. And it provides you with information on the points of entry, which means that you can either enter at year one or in year two. The specifics of this is usually provided on the Oxford website. It shows you the entry requirements for different curricula. And finally, it doesn't really show the tuition fees, kind of like Cambridge, so you're going to have to use the Oxford website to see the tuition fees. In the case of Oxford, it is better to usually see the tuition fees because it varies from subject to subject. I'm going to show you both the living costs and the course fees for Oxford. First of all, I'll show you the course fees, which usually they range from, in 2020, they ranged from £25,740 to £36,665. £36,065 is usually the cost for most of the science subjects, and for medicine it's usually higher because of the 6-year degree instead of 4. But you can go to the course listing and you'll see that you have specific information on different courses. So you need to check all of this if costs are important to you. I'll go back to the fees and funding page so that I can show you the living costs. The living costs are usually pretty high for the Oxford universities. They usually have a costs breakdown table which shows you the lower and upper ranges for all the semesters that you will be staying. So, which is usually a total of 9 months. And if I scroll down, they'll have further information and they'll explain what food entails, so you can take a look at that. And in Oxford, usually the living costs range from a lower range of £10,215 for 9 months to an upper range of £14,850 for 9 months. So that's the living costs at Oxford. So that really does end the entire UCAS search tool. You can use UCAS search tool for any university at all. It gives you a list of which universities are providing you with your course of interest. So it is actually quite helpful. So I'm going to change that now. I'm going to move over to the resources that the University of Oxford provides, which you can once again see in the fees and funding page as well. So, moving on to the scholarships. As I said before, UK does not really have financial aid for the international students. On the Oxford page, fees and funding page, you can click on the 2020 Oxford Bursaries and Scholarships website. And here on this page, you can see they have a Crankstart Scholarship and Oxford Bursaries, which is strictly for UK students. and if and this is not something that will really help the international students. Unless there is an emergency case, which you will probably have to explain to the university, an emergency usually entails very dire stances, and even then you will not get a full funding. Usually UK does not provide you with any financial aid if you're an international student. Instead, what you have is for other Oxfords, you can scroll down and look at the other Oxford scholarships available, which are usually centrally administered scholarships from the university for international students. And they're usually merit-based and looks into social commitment and occasionally need as well. And these are still quite limited, in fact. So you have to look at the scholarships that are available. Some are available for specific countries, such as the Hill Foundation Scholarship, which is available for students from the Russian Federation. It provides the entire tuition fee and a grant towards living costs. However, the Hill Foundation is only for students from Russian Federation. The DHN Foundation is only for students resident in Hong Kong. Usually for developing country students, the scholarships that you have to mainly look out for is the Reach Oxford Scholarship and the Simon and June Lee Undergraduate Scholarship. And these usually have the same deadline, and you can just click on one of them. I received the Reach Oxford Scholarship, which is actually a very good amount. You can see that here you will usually be provided with the nationalities that are eligible, which is actually, this is over 100 nationalities that are, 100 countries, over 100 countries that are eligible for this scholarship, so it is actually pretty widespread. And you have to remember that in Oxford, students studying medicine do not have any funding or scholarship available to them. So if you're going to study medicine, then you're all on your own, and you have to be sure that you have enough funding either from outside scholarships or from your home country or from loans. But Oxford itself is not going to provide you with any financial aid or scholarship for medicine. As you can see it here, all subjects are eligible in the course listing except for medicine for this scholarship. Also, another thing with these scholarships is that not all colleges are able to offer them. Some colleges do, some colleges don't. You usually don't know beforehand which colleges are going to provide you with scholarships and which won't. And you usually end up being transferred to a different college if you do end up getting a scholarship. This scholarship in particular is... It really varies from 3 year to 4 year depending on your course, and what it provides is course fees, a grant for living costs, and one return airfare per year. I'll get into the details of that scholarship, of this scholarship, later in part two of the video, so you'll have to stay tuned for part two. Also, for scholarships in Oxford, you can also go to this other website for external scholarships. They have an external scholarships page. However, this page usually, it redirects you to a lot of different scholarship search tools which you can use. However, these scholarships are usually not very bulky in amount. They're usually not sufficient to fund your entire course. So what you should be focusing on if you're applying to Oxford is those other scholarships that I mentioned earlier under the other Oxford scholarships tab. That is all for this video this time, and in the next video I'm going to go a little more into details about the Reach Oxford scholarship and what they provide, and I'll actually show you a form that I had to fill up to apply for the Reach Oxford scholarship, and I'm going to run you through that. I'm going to explain the different sections of that form and about those essays that were important and the references. So if you want to get more information on this, then subscribe to the Virtual Vine.